spoken to the remastered prologue, so this means this will be the final version of the game. Of course, it will be launched in early access in the beginning of February, but this is still a good representation of the final product, so let's play it. It was actually changed a lot, so we don't have the same enemies we had, don't have the same weapons.
Damn it.
And voice acting. It's better, but I prefer the guy with the genie in the bottle, which sounds very funny, but very, I don't know. He's the one that did the Atom RPG voice.
You are awake, just in time for the ritual. We'll have a use for you so very soon.
So yeah, they look more like ghouls and stuff like that, so they're not really vampires, because vampires are supposed to be more powerful than this.
Don't try anything funny or you'll end up like one of your friends. Perhaps I should check on him again. All that fresh blood, that must have drained by now.
That sounds very...
Doesn't look like we won that fight. I need to get out of here before this bastard returns.
Yeah, the shackles are so rusted that you can just move them away. Ta-da! We are free. We can put them back if we want to be immobilized again. Okay, let's just throw them away. We don't need them anymore. And looks like
Poor
our friend...
Luck. Your bad feeling was spot on this time. They didn't search him. Bad move. No offense, buddy. But you won't need all these things anymore.
Just look at how good the voice acting is and how nice the graphics look. Even though it's kind of pixelated, but it's... Yeah, it's the same quality as Graveyard Keeper in the graphic department. So as you can see, we need to drink and of course eat. You have more water than you have food, so be careful when you eat. Yeah, I'll just leave the hints on because sometimes you may need them. And this time I think you need more time to finish the prologue.
Alone, survivor.
So yeah, if you don't finish the prologue in one sitting, then you can't really save it, so you have to finish it each time you play it. So that's... generally good or bad, depends on the way you see it. Let's check for some secrets. As you can see, we are restoring some health because we are not full health. And we are also a bit wounded, I think. On our right leg. So this is the new injury system, which was very, very improved, as you can see. So I have hunger and thirst over here, stats over there. Traits and bio, okay, that's not available in the beta. A lot of stats and... yeah. This is a very, very complex game, so that's why I love it. It's very detailed and it shows you 100% what you can do and what you can't do. For example, your armor damage, armor penetration. So the coefficient... You actually deal damage to the armor, so you can break the enemy's armor, you can bypass it. You also have the body part damage. Which again, you can probably do some crazy stuff like disarm opponents and stuff. But that will be later on in the game. For now, we just need to equip our big piece of iron. And search for some additional loot if we can find it. Now they removed the sneaking because the sneaking was not really working as intended.
The cages are unlocked and blood trails. Seems like I was the only one to be left in the dungeon. That's strange.
Yes, it is. Wonder if it means something. So it will show you if you open the chest or the skeleton beforehand. Goat cheese, I love cheese. Spoils in 6 days. As you can see, you can sell them or eat them. So yeah, food actually plays a better...
You are dead!
So better. The voice acting is so good in this game that it actually makes you feel like you're playing a very different game. So it's turn-based combat, even though it doesn't look like it. So 10 damage. Yeah, this fight can be a very weird one because Prozelyte is the name of the enemies right now. As you can see, they deal unholy damage and you deal crushing damage. So let's be a total maniac and have a piece of iron and a shiv in the other hand. Yeah, look, it changes the way you look, of course. Also, onions. Delicious. spoils in 50 days. So it has more lead than it appears. So now let me show you some of the other things they changed.
Burn. Bled to death. Such a foolish way to go. Looks like there is a trap. I have to take a look around unless I want to share his fate.
So as you can see, we detected the trap, we disarmed it, and we avoided it successfully. He also has a little sash, fumble chance minus 1%. And the funny thing is that keeps your pens in place, but that's it. So you have a lower chances for your pens to drop in the middle of combat. So yeah, that's basically what it means. Half damage. Yeah, if you drop your pens in the middle of combat by accident, you deal less damage.
I forgot about my leg. Hurts more and more. I need to find something to treat the wound before it festers.
Yeah. As you can see, our leg injury is kind of big right now, so we have to treat every body part separately.
All these boxes, we'll surely find something in them.
Oh, we surely will find something in them.
Uh-huh. Can use this to patch up my leg.
So the way they did it is actually very different from the first time. So you open your character screen, then you click here. And you can apply the splint to stabilize it or the healing salve. But if you read the description, if the body part is injured, it has reduced efficiency. So that means we have to heal the body part before you use the healing balm. Salve. So we heal the body part with a splint. As you can see, you can apply leeches. Perform surgery. Oh, this game will get so crazy later on. So let's just apply the healing salve. Now we're healed, we're also in pain. Pain means we take more damage and we heal slower, which is a very big chance of something bad happening. Also, our fumble chance is increased. As you can see, it's 21.5. So again, being in pain is very, very bad right now. So you have to heal the pain as well. Also, now we're intoxicated. We heal slower, but we have an antidote. So, I mean, yes, you can. Let's see what happens if we don't use the antidote. So let's rest a bit. No, the game actually says it very clear. We are intoxicated. So let's use the... Right. So this makes combat very, very challenging and tricky because you'll get wounded and you'll get injured and you'll have side effects.
At least I'll live. Time to move.
It's so much better. I mean, if you take into consideration how hard combat can be and if you don't make the right choices, you'll actually get up, you'll get injuries and you'll get in a lot of pain and then you have to use medicine that you don't have. And again, it'll be such a great game when it releases. So many complex systems in place. Now actually I have a bit of armor. As you can see, it's not direct armor. It's actually resisting certain damage types. So we have 5 for now, I think. Noise produced is minus 10%, so we produce less noise again. This will be important when they reintroduce the sneak back, but an improved version of the sneaking. Again, I could throw all those things away, but I will just keep them a bit more. So the difference between the swords and the hatchet is, of course, look at the madman with a sword and the hatchet. Actually, he's now the headless horseman with a sword and an axe. You can't really see the axe, but it's there. So let's take everything. The swords have better accuracy, point plus 3%, and the axes do more damage to armor, and they have, I think, better armor penetration. Yeah. So let's do it like this. Again, you want a shield because, as I said, combat is very relentless in the game right now. You could play with the bigger two-handed weapon, but, you know, there is not such a large difference. I'm just explaining to show how complex the game can be. So, as you can see, it does more armor damage. Actually, it's the same body part damage is bigger. So if you have an opponent that is not armored, this will basically cut him in health. But the fumble chance is so big with it, and again, you just don't want to take that chance until you get better trained. So yeah, that was a lot of explaining, but I wanted to show you the differences, okay? We can recover the arrows, as you can see. Since we're not proficient with... So the guard started to bleed on his head. We got 400 experience and we got a level. So strength, body part, armor damage, perception, vitality, willpower again. Let's just put one point into there and one into strength for now. Poor guy didn't know what hit him. So this is the great part about the game. This is some kind of wine, isn't it? And an hourglass. Well, we can just sell it.
Bah, a pyromantic treatise. Just like the good old times in the academy. Got to recall a spell or two.
So now we can unlock skills. So you can't use skills or level them up in the normal way. You pick up the book. And let me show you what I mean by that. So we have abilities over here. Sorcery, pyromancy. As you can see, you need to unlock this. So let's read the book. We get fire barrage, so we can use those skills if we invest the points in them. Again, it's such a great system because if you don't find the books or if you buy the books sooner, you can actually use them. So yeah, we unlocked only 3 skills and we have to invest skill points to use them, which is great. Also, we have so many magic. Venomancy, Electromancy, Cryomancy, Astromancy, Chronomancy, Psymancy. And then you have the utility skills, which are kind of great in a way. Backstabs. Attacks on all which crit, yeah. So if we could sneak or catch someone off guard, we could do that. Some skills are not available in this prologue. So yeah, keep that in mind as well. Of course, we'll use our bow. Change weapon. Of course, they have a sheave. Also, let's read a little diary page because the story is pretty good as well. Tenth of Reaping. Also, since we read the book, we don't need it anymore. I mean, I think you can keep it to sell to the merchants, but I don't think we'll find any merchants. Actually, let's keep it, just to be on the safe side. Also, we have a monastic book, which again, we can read. That's the sixth of Reaping and so on. So these guys were not having the best time of their life. Actually, let's just keep the sheaf for fun. Okay, inventory management is one of the priorities in the game, right? So right now, I don't... Yeah, we're full HP as you can see. And full health on all the body parts. Let's read more of the diary notes. Blood was leaking from their eyes, hopelessly sick. Yeah, kind of a bad way to go. So this was some book. Ooh, so much blood. Yeah, so much blood. That's a very bloody note. Now we have more books in case you want to follow the... Oh, actually, let's break the barrels first. a tomato. That's a nice find. I mean, you always want to eat your fresh vegetables. So you get all the skills to unlock all the... I mean, you get all the books to unlock the skills, but I don't think we'll be able to use much of them. Runic armor? That's geomancy. Pyromancy number 2. I don't think this will remain the same in the final version of the game. Mace Treaty? Anyway, if you read what the book says, it's actually very silly and nonsensical sometimes. And common sense, but it's fun to read, so let's read it a bit more. The art of defense in a duel. Pay close attention to the posture and the footwork. Need to parry a strike from the left side, shift your right leg forward, bending it slightly in the knee. They did a good job with the books. I'll read them, but hey, it's... You have to hurry, so that's the dagger, and that is the war axe. Mutilating lunge, cutting through. Great books, I tell you. Also the ranged weapons. The great sword. Of course we have the shield expertise. And also the staves. So once again, this will play out in the way that you want to design your character. So he can be a hybrid or he can be a very, very specialized character. Identification scroll. To be honest, when I played the other... I mean, I played before I started the video. I got a gold ring somewhere else, but now I didn't get it. So I don't have anything to identify, and we also have to drink a bit more water. Had a cool little animation over there, did you see that? Watch again. Water. Okay, now we are fully hydrated. Some items will be cursed. You are warned. Sure. Perfectly understandable. So now this is where the hard part of the game begins. I think I'll play the game a few more times. This bat was vicious. So they were conducting some weird experiments over here. 4 points of damage, fumble. So the bat does a little bit of a poison damage, watch out for that. Also again, this will lower the durability, but it's still 100 because it's a good weapon. As you can see, the sword has lower durability. So keep that in mind as well when you're... Ooh. What's he doing? He's restoring health and... Is this guy being healed? Oh, we actually hit him. Okay, let's get closer, but it's... Oh, he stepped into a trap, that's why he's stuck. We are dazed. Okay, that was a bit scary because I don't know how good enemies are right now. I didn't play much of the combat because I wanted to be a surprise for me. We are in pain. And we just have to heal that. But now we're actually intoxicated and I don't have anything to heal that. So I should have taken a little break. I'm not sure if this is the right thing to do because... As I told you, the game is very relentless right now. Very unforgiving. Well, I won't use the thing or that thing. Ah, let's actually identify this one. So this is a balanced broadaxe, accuracy and shock damage. Well, that's pretty good. 30 slashing damage. That is so much better. Such a big improvement. Also, we'll keep this one. Ah, let's just throw that away. Ooh, I didn't see this one. That's shaky. So let's rest a bit because we lost a lot of health in that fight. Hey. Yeah, the game is much more improved right now. I mean, enemies can open the doors and they'll come to attack you from all sides and directions. Yeah, no, this won't work. So I need to eat properly right now. Let's see the tomato. There's nothing I can do about the pain. As if you remember, this is randomly generated, so I can play this more than once. Okay. Started bleeding, right leg. That was a singular strike. So we have a fist shield, which means it's what? The block chance is lower. To be honest, it's not really worth it. But also, let's search the chest. I'm not sure I'll be able to finish the game with this playthrough, but I'll just do my best. We have a falchion. These potions can be very, very strong or very, very weak, depending on your luck. Let's see. Let's end the video right here and I'll do another one right after this one. Bye.